actually, Jeff, you forgot, you're working for Janet. So I wasn't going to tell Brian Hall's story, but if you heard earlier today, Brian Hall had been a residence hall. We called it dorm back then. And when we lived there, there was a chandelier in the middle. And many of us were standing around one day, and a gentleman walked in with his wife. And she went off and down the hallway, and he stood in the lobby. And we said, well, come on in. And I think Janet was there, Dr. Gruden was there, because I hope you remember this, and I hope it wasn't just me. And he said, I can't, because when it was a dorm, this is as far as I could go. We go a long way. So before I say a few words, and I will say a few words, I first have to thank some people. First, family, students, friends, for being here to support Janet. This is a special occasion. Her 31 years of work deserves our attendance and our recognition. So thank you all. Certainly, I'd like to start to thank the speakers for their remarks, but also our guitarist. I think he's already left. Cody Switzer did a fabulous job early. You also saw the work that went into creating this environment to honor Janet. And when I put out an APB, we're going to put this retirement party together, and showed up in a room, who would imagine the number of people that showed up on our team? And so I'd like to thank Jackie Bell, Jamie Lynn Cook, Tracy Gowling, Casey Dozier, Carrie Fee, Lisa Francis, Emily Kennelly, Lauren Cooney, Kristen Martin, Leslie Milley, Amanda Sargent, Geneva Scott, Bob Reardon, Calvin Williams, and Kelly Gilmer. So thank you all. It's going to be hard for me to keep within the 3 to 5 minutes. But what I realized is that I knew the people that were speaking, and I knew what they do. They talk about your work. They talk about the commitment that you've made to this institution, to career advising, to the career center, to students. The commitment that you made to this profession, Janet, to NCDA, to these students out here, and all of those that you have touched. I travel across this country, and I hear, oh, you were Janet Lenz. And that's the truth. And so I knew I didn't have to talk about that. And so I thought, how do I honor this person that I've had the privilege of working with for 31 years? What is the legacy to me? And you heard it through a lot of the speakers. But to me, it's summed up in the word called character. And so Janet, Steve Marabella said, the truth of your character is expressed through the choice of your actions. And I want to talk about three of those actions that I have been privileged to see by working with you for all these years. When I think of what character means to me, the first thing I think of is goodness or generosity of spirit. And you heard that in Dawn's presentation. But let me tell you what, folks, you don't see it like some of us see it. But when anyone's hurt, or someone has a problem, or there is an issue, she is the first to show up. And not just show up, she is the first with the kind word, the deed, the action, and the dollars to make things happen, and then doesn't want to be recognized for it. That kindness and that goodness, Janet, is something I'll always honor. The second is integrity. Doing what you say and saying what you're going to do. Right? And I knew if Janet said it's going to get done, it was going to get done. That's why she was asked to be interim director. Because we all knew we could count on her. And I counted on you so much these last 5 years, you cannot even imagine. I will tell you this, this event has been hard for her, though. You heard Bob coming down to the office and telling me what Janet wanted. She's not in control now. We're doing this our way. The third thing that I think of when I think of character, though, is courage. And courage can mean a lot of things at a lot of times. But in Janet's instance, what it means to me is that it's doing the right thing, even when it's hard. And it's telling you the things you need to hear, even when they're hard to hear them. And so all those times, you came down and closed the door, and we had conversations. It was done with love, respect, and honor for what was best for this institution, what was best for the Career Center, and what was best for me and for others. So, Janet, I will always thank you for that courage. I will expect my door to be closed many times because I gave you the office you wanted down the hall. This is how generous she was. We created a really nice space for her, and she came and shut the door one day and said, I really think Casey should have that nice office. And those are things you don't hear about Janet. And so, Janet, know that I am a better person because you have challenged me, you have supported me, you have encouraged me, and simply you've just been there for me. There is no one I'd rather go into battle with than Janet Lenz. So, Janet, on behalf of the Career Center, we do your work. And we wouldn't have it any other way.